Hello and welcome to Off Broadway Boutique presents Positively Lynn. And to tell you today is Positively New York, Positively the Italian Welfare League luncheon, and Positively this exciting city on a fall day. And I'm sitting in a wonderful, handsome cab, ready to go to the plaza. And here we go. We are going to have such an exciting time for you today. We have a fashion show. And if we're lucky, we're going to interview Donna Guliani. And we're very excited about that, and a lot of special people. There's going to be a terrific fashion show, and this is New York the way it should be. Exciting and wonderful, with a little breeze in the air, and maybe a little rain, but it hasn't started raining yet. So welcome to Off-Broadway Boutique presents Positively Lynn, and come on in with me to the Plaza Hotel. And if somebody would help take me out of this handsome cab, I would be delighted. This is living. Thank you so much. Artie Nichols. Woo! Artie Nichols is our driver, and he has this handsome cab. And if you want a terrific ride in New York, you must ride with Artie Nichols. It's a beautiful cab and a beautiful day, and we welcome you all. Come on in to the Plaza Hotel, one of the most glamorous hotels in New York. Now I'll tell you about what I'm wearing. I am wearing a silk outfit that we make at Off-Broadway, long pointed sides. That's it, Richie, let's show them. Here we go, I'm gonna twist around and show you. Long pants, stunning without pants if you're little and tiny. Long pearls, a roll on my head, curls. Remember, more is better, have fun. No matter what size you are, this is one size fits most. You can have a ball with the clothing. Okay, come on now into the plaza because the cabs are blowing. The handsome is ready to go, and come on inside. We are standing here with Vera Cugini. Do I have your name right?
Yes, you do. Cugini.
Cugini.
Cousin.
Who is the hostess of this marvelous luncheon of the Italian Welfare League. And we are standing in front of a table full of delights, and I'd like you to tell us a little bit about it. Welcome, Vera.
Well, thank you, and thank you for coming and putting on such a wonderful show for us.
You haven't seen it yet. Wait till it's out.
I know. Just looking at you, I know it has to be a great show, Lynn. These are lovely gifts that were donated by very generous companies and individual friends. And as you can see, we have them wrapped, so you can't see many of them, but we have lovely baskets from of cheer. And the Bone people gave us this lovely bust of Columbus, indigenous to Italians. And we have some things from Mr. Lordy, and a suit from Donna Karen, a man's suit. We have Karen Stevens, we have Jeffrey Bean, we have...
Wait a minute,
Helen Greco's beautiful fur.
They look fantastic. How does one win these?
Oh, very simply, you just take chances, as many as you possibly can,
yes,
so that you can be a winner of one of these wonderful gifts.
They look so gorgeous. There are a few things there that I'd like.
Yes.
I think I have to buy some chances myself.
And we have a piece of lovely piece of jewelry here.
Ooh,
necklace donated from a jeweler. Isn't that lovely?
Wow.
Now, for $10, is that not worth winning?
Ah.
And how about a trip for two to Italy?
That I would love most of all.
For $10, if you take one chance. But now if you take five chances, you have five more chances to get it.
You know what? I want to take a chance.
Great.
Where do I buy it? Can I buy it during the luncheon?
Sure. Why don't we sell her a chance right here and
absolutely
now?
Absolutely. I would love it. I
we
would
have
love
no
it.
Chances out here now.
I will get it.
We'll put them on your table inside.
Vera, I'm sure you could write a book about doing this luncheon. What an experience. You call it an adventure, right?
It sure is. It's a lovely, it's a good deed. It's a lot of work and a lot of fun, and I've enjoyed very much. I've enjoyed very much.
You are a delight, and I'm sure the luncheon will be wonderful.
I hope so.
It will be, and our fashion show will give you all we have, baby.
I know. I would never have gone to you if I thought differently.
I thank you for shopping at Off-Broadway, and I thank you for being as charming, and we're going to see your daughter, Marvel, today.
Yes, you are. I'm sorry my other daughter couldn't make it, who was able to get the Dolans for us to come. The Dolans are here. Bob Brandt is here. Mrs. Giuliani is here. This is exciting.
Absolutely exciting. And thanks
thank
so
you,
much, sweetheart. I know you want to go in for the luncheon.
Thank you.
Well, here again, I'm at the Grand Ballroom of the Plaza at the Italian Welfare League, and you'll never know who just showed up. Mary Teresa, who is a terrific gal, who is a client of ours, and who is wearing a gorgeous Frank Olive hat, Broadway hat.
Wouldn't go anywhere else but Off Broadway for my hats and clothes.
I
was so smashing, and if you didn't wear that hat, I was going to wear that hat today.
Well, I'm glad I got there before you did.
Thanks, Mary Teresa. Have a wonderful day at this luncheon.
Thank you very much, and success to your show.
Stay tuned. Stay tuned. We have a terrific guest next. Stay with us. I have a very special lady sitting next to me, really special, and this time of year is most special for her. Her name is?
Donna Hanover Guliani.
Absolutely, Donna, welcome.
Thank you very much.
Now, tell me about you. First of all, you've been an anchor woman.
That's right. That's right. I'm a journalist. I anchored news in several cities, Pittsburgh, Columbus, Ohio, and Miami, before I met Rudy. I was working in Miami when I met him. And then I came up to New York after I met him, and I anchored news on Channel 11 for many years. People will remember my anchor lady hair, probably.
Is that what it is? You're so sweet looking. I had no idea what you looked like, really. Now tell me, you have two children.
I have two children, a 7-year-old boy, Andrew, and a 4-year-old girl, Caroline,
which we're going to put on camera in a little while.
It's going to come on in a few minutes here.
Now tell me, what is it running for this race? What do you feel? What is it like being a wife?
It's tremendously exciting. The campaign is wonderfully exciting. We're feeling very optimistic. Of course, the polls are looking very good, which makes it a little easier to be optimistic. But also, when we meet people on the street, whatever their heritage or their whatever kind of work they do, they come up to us and they say it's so important for Rudy to get elected. So we're getting a lot of feedback that people really, really want to see a change in the city. They're tired of the crime. They're upset about the 350,000 jobs that have been lost from the city in the last 4 years. And they think they need a mayor who has some vision and some intention to change things.
Tell me, as a mother of two, what would you like to see most changed in the city?
Well, I'm concerned about the crime, of course. I have two little children, and I worry about the day that they want to go someplace without supervision. And that day will come. And so the crime is a particular problem. I think it's important that we start arresting low-level drug dealers again. One of the reasons there are so many shootings in the streets, innocent people, is because low-level drug dealers are not being arrested in very large numbers, and they still have their guns, and they're having these gun battles. And I think we need to offer drug treatment on demand for people, and this is Rudy's program too. This is for people who finally reached bottom and say, I'm ready to get some help. Now the city turns them away and says, come back in 60 days. Well, what do you think they're going to do for the next 60 days? They're going to victimize other people. So I think if we can solve some of those problems, we can reduce the problem of homelessness, the problem of child abuse, a lot of the problems throughout our society.
That sounds wonderful, and certainly I love New York. I've lived in New York for so many years. I just want to see it continue and get better and better and better, as well you.
And New York is the center of the universe, and it should stay that way.
Right. How did you meet Rudy?
As I said, I was anchoring news in Miami. It was kind of a blind date. I met someone who said, I have a friend named Rudy that goes to Miami a lot. Would you like to go out with him? And by the way, he'd make a good interview. And I have to tell you that when he called me, I kind of gave him a hard time being a reporter. And I said, what three things do you love? He said, opera, baseball, and New York City. And I said to myself, this is not a permanent relationship. Because I like country western music and football, and I was pretty happy being warm during the winter. But I fell in love with him, and within 6 weeks he asked me to marry him.
Oh my heavens.
He's that very decisive guy.
Does he listen to it all? I mean, how involved are you with this campaign, and does he really take your advice?
He does. He's a person, one of the things that I fell in love with was that he is a person who is very intelligent and very witty, and a person with an open mind. He listens when other people bring ideas to the table. And so, yes, we have a partnership. He would be the mayor. If you're voting for him, you're voting for him, and I will do what I can to serve the city.
Not voting for you, Donna, a little bit, because you seem so soft and lovely. I mean, my vote would go for you immediately, I must tell you, being a woman.
Thank
yes,
you.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you.
Now, tell me, I know they're having a big thing October 12th. What's going on October 12th?
Oh, thank you for asking. We have a women's coalition for Giuliani. We had an event in June at which 1,100 women came. So it kind of knocked the socks off of everybody. They were thrilled. And it was, according to our political consultant, the best event the campaign had had up to that point. On October 12th at 5:30 at the Sheraton, we're going to be having, it's called the countdown reception because it'll be exactly 3 weeks out from the election. And we're hoping to double the number of women that we had. And the message is really, a lot of thinking women have chosen Giuliani, and we hope other concerned women will think about it too. We think that if women who care about the city see a huge number of other women, everybody, investment bankers, teachers, nurses, full-time mothers, if they see those people together pulling in one direction, they'll say, hey, maybe this is a guy I should think about voting for also.
Donna, politics is one thing, but let's get down to the nitty-gritty. Tell me about this food program you're going to be involved in. What is that?
Well, you know, people often ask me what would be my plans as First Lady. And, of course, the first thing would be to raise my two children. The second thing would be to take care of my husband.
Yes.
Thirdly, I intend to continue working at least part-time because I think the image of a two-career couple who both support each other's work and like each other's work is important. And I'm going to be doing a new television program. It's a news program about food issues on a new cable channel called the Television Food Network. It'll be national, and it has clearance in New York, although I don't know which channel yet. And I'll be talking about FDA regulations and allergy crises and nutrition and lots of different issues related to food. Now, I'm not much of a cook myself.
But how are you going to do this, then?
I'm a consumer. We're all consumers.
Okay. So what is the theme of the show?
The theme of the show is it's the daily news program on food issues. So it'll be whatever is in the news that day related to food issues, restaurant tax deductions, that sort of thing. So it'll be the news of the day. We'll be doing interviews with newsmakers in the food industry. I will be interviewing cookbook authors. We'll probably be looking at new products that are being developed because occasionally you go to the grocery store and there's something new you never even heard about it. It'd be nice to have sort of a consumer reports about things.
Right. Sounds good to me. Now, how do you people live today? How do you go to a movie? How has your life changed since this campaign?
Well, the campaign, of course, is getting very, very intense, and there aren't many days off.
Right.
We took one day off in August together alone and went to the beach, and then we took another day off alone with the children and took them to the beach. And we have one day planned off on October 4th. And after that, no holidays.
No holidays until November 2nd.
Until November 2nd.
First
right.
Tuesday, is
Please
it in November?
To vote. Uh-huh. It's very, very important.
I think everybody should vote no matter who they vote for. My feeling is you must vote. I mean, to give up that is
it's a
terrible
great honor.
Thing.
People have died to give us that honor, and we must exercise it. Whoever you're going to vote for, I really feel it's important that you go to vote.
Now, I can't ask you, but I will ask you, what are you doing at the Italian Welfare League, which is very interesting.
I'm having a wonderful time. Of course, my husband is very proud of being Italian-American.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And although I am part Polish and part Czech and part Irish and part English, my children are half Italian-American.
That's right. That's very exciting.
I also think the Italian Welfare League does wonderful work for the people of this area. The charity, the helping hand to people in need is something that we need to see more of. And so I think the people here are really to be respected and saluted for what they do.
I agree with you. Now tell me, what is Rudy like? Is he a good daddy? What kind of a father is he?
He's a good daddy. He loves to take Andrew to baseball games, and he loves to read to Caroline. And Caroline and Rudy dance every morning before he goes to work. They sing, Somewhere Over the Rainbow or the Barney Song or something like that. And they dance, and he's the prince and she's the princess. So he has
Donna,
a wonderful relationship.
Donna, that's hard to believe, this powerhouse guy dancing with your daughter. I love it. If it's really true, I love it.
It's true.
It is true. I can only tell you, I want to meet your daughter, and I hear she's right here now. We're going to be lucky enough. Here she comes.
Caroline,
we're ready for you. Come on.
Come on.
Tell me about you, Caroline. Oh, I love her dress and her hairdo.
Well, she knew she was coming to a fancy ladies' lunch.
Carolyn, how do you like a fancy ladies' lunch? Do you like it?
Who do you think everybody should vote for?
Who?
Daddy, what's his name?
What's Daddy's name? Say it loud.
Rudy.
Say it loud.
Loud.
Rudy.
Rudy. So you want everybody to vote for Rudy. How old are you?
How old are you?
Four.
Oh, and that's such a pretty band in your hair. And I hear you dance with your daddy in the morning. Is that true? Do you dance with your daddy? What dance?
What do you sing? You sing Rainbow?
Over the Rainbow.
Over the Rainbow? That's a lovely song. I'm so glad. You know you're going to be on television now, and everybody's going to see that cute face and that blonde hair. Are you having a good time at the luncheon?
Yeah.
What did you eat so far?
Bread and butter. And grapes.
And do you know, Carolyn, Caroline, we're going to do a gorgeous fashion show. And you're going to see fashions that when you're a big girl, you're going to come and buy beautiful clothes and wear them, okay?
Is that good? She has a lovely dress, a hand-me-down satin dress, and when I put it on her for her birthday, she said, this is a getting married dress.
Oh, I love it. They start when they're born, honest to God. I really think it. Donna, I thank you
so much.
You're
so gracious.
Really, you are a lovely person, and I wish you the best of good luck with your husband and your family and everything.
Thank you.
You have a delightful daughter. Maybe someday I'll get to meet the son.
Wonderful.
Carolyn, thank you for coming to our TV show.
You're welcome.
Caroline? You're welcome. Thank you. Thank you. Bye-bye now.
Lynn Dell. And the name of the shop is called Off Broadway Boutique. About a year ago, I had done the Regis Philbin show, I had done Oprah Winfrey's show, I had done Attitudes with Lynn and Dana, and I decided I should have my own show. I didn't know what I was doing. I had no idea how to do it. It was wonderful to do other people's shows because all it was 7 minutes of success. All you did is speak for 7 minutes on TV and then go home. Well, doing your own show is a lot more difficult. I love it. It's a challenge. And I heard Helen Greco say that she decided to do what's difficult in life. There's a saying that says, do something that terrifies you. Everything else is boring. And that's what I decided to do. We dress all the theater people, we dress all the opera stars, we make lots of things in one size fits all. I have met the most delicious people here today. I mean, from Donna Guliani to the Dolans to the president of the organization. There are a few of my very dear customers in the audience today, and one of them is sitting there in the hat. Please stand up, Mary Teresa. She just bought that hat this week. If she didn't buy the hat, I was going to wear it, because on television, you must wear something off your face, otherwise they don't see you at all. And you look lovely. Camille, please, would you stand up? Camille has been a loyal customer for many, many years. She is dressed from off-Broadway, from head to toe. Camille and her daughter and her family, we thank you for shopping. And Vera, who's the hostess of this luncheon, is a very good customer. Vera, we thank you. And Vera's daughter is going to be one of our models today. Now, for those of you who are sitting all the way down at the end, find a chair and come up close so you can see the runway. I want you to sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Please move your chairs nearer if you like. If you can't see, please do that. By the way, we have a cable show. It's called Off Broadway Boutique Presents Positively Lynn. This show, and many of you will be on TV. And if you call Vera or you call Doris, my assistant at the store, they'll tell you when. It's about 3 to 4 weeks. The show will be aired on TV. We're on Channel 17 every Thursday evening at 8:30. And then the show repeats Tuesday morning at 11 a.m. on Channel 17. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy this whole show, because the luncheon is not a luncheon without a fashion show. Now can we have some music? Maestro, please, let's get on with the show. Elegance, Pierre, three-piece pantsuit. Check, Camelot Brown, elegant. Notice the hat and the accessories, all important to make the outfit. Three-piece pantsuit, lovely. If you're unsure about what length to wear, pants are always wonderful. And don't let anybody tell you what length to wear. can be short one day and long the next day. Pierre, lovely. Thank you so much.
Good girl. I want to wait in here. I don't see the bell.
Nina. Nina in total black. By the way, ladies, if you want to look 10 pounds slimmer immediately, just wear total black. Color is divine, but there's nothing, nothing like black. This is a U front pantsuit. The length would be good at any length. Black felt hat with a gorgeous shawl with tassels. Elegant and beautiful. Fashion tip, remember this. If you have a big face and you wear a large earring, you will look smaller. If you have a tiny face and you want to fill it out, you wear a large earring. Make a statement. Thank you, Nina. Lovely. Here's a gal, Sydney, who just became Mrs. New York, and she's going into the Mrs. America contest. Sydney has been modeling with us for many years. Three-piece camel gabardine pantsuit, easy, comfortable, and lovely, with a big black picture hat. And remember, a total look is the hat, the shoes, the jewelry, everything makes a fashion statement. And Cindy has a delicious little boy. And Cindy, we wish you luck in Mrs. America. Charlene is gorgeous. She has modeled for years. She's been modeling for us for years. And I'm going to tell you a little secret about Charlene. I promise I won't give your age, Charlene. Charlene goes from a 10 to a size 16, and she's as gorgeous no matter what size she is. So remember, it's not what size you are, it's your attitude. And you must always take care of yourself no matter what size you are. Thank you, Charlene. That two-piece black wool crepe suit. Here is Pat. Most of you who are clients in our store know Pat. She knows everything that's going on 72nd Street. She's a fashion coordinator. On the side, she does a little psychiatry work too. So if you're having a problem, you come to Off-Broadway and Pat will settle any problem you have. Pat is wearing a wool crepe suit from PSI with an ultra suede high waistline tie. Notice the shawls with the fringe, the challis. From Italy, as a matter of fact, they're gorgeous, aren't they? And her hat in taupe, total look, just beautiful. Pat, that's lovely, thank you. Corey, here's another gal. She's been modeling with us for maybe 12 years. She went from a size 6 to a size 16. She's as gorgeous today, I think even more beautiful, but that's a terrible thing to say. She just had a baby, a gorgeous little boy, and she's beautiful. Corey is wearing a camel wrap pantsuit, and we have a fake fur felt hat on in leopard with a long leopard scarf. Corey, you look divine in that. It's comfortable, isn't it? She's lovely. Look at that face. Is she a beauty or is she a beauty? Thank you. And now we have Vera's daughter, Janine. Is she a delicious gift? Hi, Janine. Is she adorable? Janine is wearing a black suit with a captain's hat, and you can tell she enjoys it. She's wonderful. She almost forgot to come back and change into her clothes for modeling, for she was having such a wonderful time. Janine, you're delicious in that. Do you feel good in it? Yes, she's as comfortable on the runway as she was up at the podium. Janine, thank you so much. You know, ladies, to dress up is wonderful. This is something we make at Off-Broadway Boutique. We're giving you a test, a little bit of everything. You have to have a lot of attitude to wear this outfit. That's a big baker's hat, a black and white knit coat. Notice the stripes going in two waves. The that the coat is this beautiful over solid black or solid white. It's easy, it's comfortable, it's one size fits all, and it's very dramatic. We make this in solid colors too, if you're a little more timid. It can be worn with a skirt, it's a sleeveless vest, and black and white stripes are in. Thank you so much, Pierre. Now comes her sister, Nina. Nina, again, is wearing an off-Broadway outfit. She's wearing the solid coat. Over it, it's fun. It's delightful. Remember, ladies, you never get a second chance to make a first impression. Always have fun with your clothes. They're going to switch coats. Are they cute or are they cute? I mean, that's fun. You don't have to wear the hat, but it makes an outfit. Girls, you're delicious. Help each other. Great. As a cake, it's fine, too. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Thank you, ladies.
Would you believe we're in the middle of the fashion show and we've run out of time? And I want you to know we're coming back next week with more, because we can't let you hang like this. You're going to see more, so tune in next week. And remember, we're on every Thursday at 8:30 p.m., Channel 17, and then the show repeats Tuesday morning at 11 a.m. So thank you so much for watching, and come back and see us next week.
Such excitement. Cars, hansom cabs, limousines, everything you can think of, taxis. This is one of the most exciting places in New York. Now, did I promise you we'd have another great show? And didn't we do that? So please tell a friend to watch us. And the Italian Welfare League, we wish you luck, we wish you hope, we want you to do well. And as far as the mayor of New York, whoever wins, great. We just want a better city, because we love this city so much. We really want a better city. So may the best man win. And thank you for joining us, and please come and see us next week. Join us next week. Bye-bye now.
You got to accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to the affirmative. Don't mess with Mr. In-Between. You got to spread joy up to the maximum, bring gloom.